Hello, my name is Adam, and today I'll guide you through the process of generating an API key. Additionally, I'll demonstrate how you can leverage Postman, a free tool, to send transactional emails via an API. If you're not experienced with email sending, you might not know why and how to use an API. API stands for an application programming interface and is used as a connector between applications to perform certain functions. Utilizing an email API enables the integration of an email service provider's functionalities into your own application or website. As a result, you can effortlessly send transactional or bulk emails directly from your app or web page, taking advantage of your ESP. Establishing an API connection may present difficulties for inexperienced users, yet it promises swift delivery, enhanced security featuring multi-level API keys, and advanced analytics. However, the need for coding proficiency and the frequent updates associated with APIs may be hard for some users. These issues are typically managed by application developers, technical marketers, and companies with programming teams. Elastic Email provides various integrations and API libraries to simplify the utilization of our API keys. You can discover all available third-party integrations here. The API key is accessible in both marketing and API products. Before creating an API key, ensure that your domain has been verified. If you haven't completed this step yet, please refer to this guide. To generate an API key, go to the Settings section. From there, you can create an API key by first specifying its name. Moreover, you can customize additional restrictions such as IP address limitations and expiration dates there. It's now time to address permissions. We offer predefined permission templates such as full access, view only, and ready for plugin. However, you can also customize these according to your preferences and requirements, making decisions on specific settings one by one. Keep in mind that you need to activate send email via HTTP if you wish to send emails using this API key. Once everything is configured, simply click the Create button to complete the process. The API key is displayed on this pop-up. It's crucial to save it because it won't be visible again. If you miss it, you'll need to change the API key or generate a new one. On this screen, you'll find all generated API keys along with their assigned accesses. You have the option to edit or delete any of them. With our key generated, we're prepared to send emails via API. We will use the Postman application to send an email. It's a free-to-use API platform for building and using these APIs. Let's delve into how to send an email. The application has already been installed and the account has been configured. Now let's create a new workspace. We'll start by creating a new collection and adding a new request. Let's begin with authentication. You'll find a dedicated space where you must input your API key within the value section. Use the provided input as the key and include it in the header. Switch the method from get to post as we are sending an email and not receiving it. Add the specified URL and replicate the remaining parameters from our documentation. Within the body section, opt for raw and JSON to ensure the code is formatted correctly. I'll employ a simple code consistent with Elastic Email's documentation. Input the recipient's email address in the designated field. In the content area, specify both the format and the content of the message. While the content typically entails a text message sent to your audience, you also have the option to utilize a template from your account. Under From, specify the sender's details in accordance with your verified domain, along with the subject line for dispatch. Once all settings are configured, we can proceed to send a test email. Here, you'll observe the response status. A code of 200 indicates that the email was successfully sent. Additionally, you'll find the data payload generated by Elastic Email. As you can see, the email has been delivered, so the API connection has been set up correctly. Congratulations! It's just a simple example, but it shows the logic behind the API key. If you have any questions on this topic, our customer support team is ready to provide guidance and offer additional help. Have a great day!